If you haven't heard of Cozy Games, you've either been living under a rock or been stuck inside of a MetaQuest 2 for 3 years. For anybody who isn't familiar with the concept of Cozy Games, let me explain. Have you ever wanted to play a game but didn't want to blow the heads off your enemies? Or you don't want to get mad from dying to those stupid Burbos on the darker side for the 48th time? Well, it's time to sit back, relax, and harvest some crops. I released a new track called Haya. You should go give it a listen. Hyper 8-bit EDM, you can't go wrong. Anyway, let's get on with it. You can go farming, run your own kitchen, or even just organize until your heart's content. Cozy games are often filled with simple, repetitive tasks that slowly etch away toward a larger goal. Sometimes this main goal is a crucial moment in the game, but other times it's open-ended and you're left to keep playing until you stop from eventually forgetting about the game or because you've put so many hours into it that you feel nauseated just thinking about it. Keep in mind for this that cozy is a very subjective term. There are some general characteristics that most of these games have, but nothing is set in stone. What is cozy to me might not be as cozy to you, and vice versa. I first got familiar with the concept last summer when I opened up the Steam store to see Wholesome Direct. I wanted them all. They were all adorable. Different puzzles, adventures, and simulators. My cart quickly filled up and I took way too long figuring out which ones I could afford right then and which ones would end up on the wish list for the next sale. I ended up getting Smushy Come Home, Unpacking, and Power Wash Simulator. Around the same time, the YouTube gods recommended Gab Smolders and I watched her play a ton of cozy games. Let's just say, it was a very cozy month. I finally had a name for these types of games I had always liked. I'm not a huge fan of multiplayer, and while I've played my fair share of shooters, I'm definitely not the person out here waiting for the next R6 or COD. I've always preferred single-player, unique, low-barrier-to-entry games that have a warm, inviting nature. And here they were. The title of earliest cozy game is often given to Harvest Moon on the Super Nintendo. This is what most farming simulators are built from. You know, your Animal Crossings, your Stardew Valleys. It's all about farming, collecting, building friendships, and most importantly, relaxing. They often surround a daily cycle where many times you'll have a few chores to do and then you spend the rest of the day working toward whichever goal you deem as most important of the time. You often find yourself having the feeling of, oh, I'll just play one more day that inevitably turns into at least five more. This gameplay loop is how a lot of these games thrive. Let's bring my new obsession, Stardew Valley, into the spotlight. Every day I wake up at 6 a.m. and head out to water my crops, pet all my animals, go check the cave for new mushrooms, and then I choose one of the other 30 things that I could be doing that day. The day cycle is only like 15 minutes or something, so you can really only work on one thing for so long before the game makes you take a break. But as I'm walking back from the mines, I see the construction shop. Gotta save up for the deluxe barn, which means I need to expand my farm a little bit. Oh wait, Demetrius wants a bunch of albacore by the end of the week. Maybe I should do that tomorrow. The game never penalizes you for missing something. There's always another chance to catch that fish or find those berries. You're never left with nothing to do. If you're standing around wondering what's next, it's not because you've ran out of things to do, it's because you have to choose one of the many things you could be doing. And sometimes you try to choose everything, but you'll never make it to the blacksmith by 4. That's okay, there's always tomorrow. Let's go over the 4 main categories of cozy games. With any game, there can be some crossover, but generally they fall into one of these main categories. And there are some honorable mentions that we'll say the stairs of this cozy cathedral are made out of. The first pillar, of course, has to be the farm sims that we already went over. The second is what I'm calling non-farming simulators. Third is design games, and the fourth is exploration games. One of the earliest success stories for simulators was, well, naturally, The Sims. Take control of a person living their life. Make them cook dinner, make them practice their speech, take away the ladder from the pool so they eventually get exhausted, have no way to get out, and end up...
Hey, Chai.
Yeah?
Corporate says we need to cut that from the script.
Ah, whatever. Build a nursery from the ground up, run your own kitchen, or become a toxicologist. Simulators often have you running some kind of business, operation, or maybe just a little street. They normally have little to no penalties for going at your own pace or doing your own thing, and will often reward curiosity with hidden events or items. These games can be really appealing by offering a fun way to explore an unfamiliar experience. Oh wow, I've never used a power washer before. I wonder if it's as satisfying as it looks. It is. It gives you just a glimpse of a world that we may have no familiarity with. I've never owned a chicken, but when I played Cheeky Chooks, I had a blast rearranging the decorations, making sure I had enough water, and of course trying to find all of the chickens wearing hats. I accidentally played this stupid chicken game for 3 hours. I do recommend if you have a couple hours to kill. It's that gameplay loop. A lot of these simulators will often have timers for different things so that you can go do something else while waiting for that thing to be done. It encourages players to come back to check every so often. Third is our design games. At their core, these games are just about designing something. You can dress some characters, design a room, organize a bookshelf. Do you like to make things look aesthetically pleasing? Then these are for you. I highly recommend Unpacking. It follows a girl moving through life via the different houses and apartments she moves to. You see her meet people, find out what she values, and so much more. And the whole story is told just from you unpacking boxes into her new homes. It's a wonderful story told in such a unique and satisfying way. Please go check it out if you think you might be at all interested. The last pillar is exploration games. These games can often be criticized for being walking simulators from those who are looking for a more involved gaming experience. But if you just want to explore the wilderness, these games may be perfect for you. Firewatch is a game that kept getting recommended to me when researching. That's 2 videos in a row where this game has been brought to my attention, and I still really want to get my hands on that map and compass to see what it's all about. So, I did. And just wow, this game was way better than I expected. It has a really good story, and the map and compass were perfect. They really let me scratch that adventuring itch right here in the middle of winter. If you do play this, make sure to turn off show location on map to have a more immersive experience. I think any game with a beautiful environment could be played as a cozy exploration game. Now that we have our pillars, let's go over our few honorable mentions. First are your visual novels. Not really my cup of tea, but they are definitely popular. Typically, you'll just follow a story along as if you're reading a book, usually making some dialogue choices along the way. They're essentially virtual choose-your-own-adventure books. Next, we have the similar, but slightly different, visual experiences. These games take pride in just that, being beautiful. And last, I want to add in puzzle games. Puzzles are found across almost every genre, but the go-at-your-own-pace, relaxing, often adorable puzzle games lend themselves to be very cozy indeed. Like I mentioned before, there is a lot of overlap and most games will fall into one or more categories, but now that we have an idea of what these games are, let's figure out why this cozy explosion happened. Cozy games is a newer term for a familiar concept. It seems the term started in the mid to late 2010s. This journal was written in 2017 by a team at Project Horseshoe, which was an annual conference where thought leaders in game design and development would get together to try to solve game design's toughest problems. The article goes into what is cozy, the different facets of coziness, and how cozy games can appeal to wider audiences. Of course, it goes very in-depth. But if you're a nerd and interested in game design at all, go give it a read. It gets crazy in there. They're talking about Maslow's hierarchy of needs and permissive communication channels. It's a wild ride. Around the same time, we started seeing this term floating around a lot more. Cozy games. We started to get more and more games that fell into this cozy little basket. Donut Country, Sayonara Wild Hearts, Wadum. But then something big happened. Now listen. I'm not gonna go do the whole bring up COVID in some dramatic fashion describing how we were all alone in a time of confusion and uncertainty and we all had hours to waste so we could devote it to video games. I just did it, didn't I? Oh well. Yes, we all remember waking up every day, digging up rocks, shaking trees, and working on our islands. It really lent a strong sense of connection and routine in a time where a lot of us didn't have either. This led to a huge spike in more casual gamers entering into the world, while also bringing along many serious gamers. And what better way to get cozy than by grabbing a warm mug of coffee and your Nintendo Switch and plopping onto the couch to decorate your way to a 5-star island. Cozy gamers love their Switches. Everywhere you look, you'll find people searching for or sharing Switch games. And it makes sense. Nothing cozier than a console you can cuddle up with and even take to bed if you're feeling frisky. A lot of players want that full-body cozy experience. They have everything they might need. A TV playing a Lo-Fi Beats YouTube stream, a snack, and a beautiful game to play. Cozy games often feature cute aesthetics, whether that be soft color palettes, unique art styles, and of course, an endless supply of cute characters. You'll often find yourself saying, "Aww," whenever you meet a new villager or friend. The sounds used in these games will typically be softer and not as harsh and sudden. Think of the voices of Animal Crossing villagers, or the satisfying clicks of picking up items in Minecraft. So you've got your soft blankets, aromatic brew, aesthetic visuals, and calming sounds. What's left? Well, a heartwarming story. Maybe you're looking for a new partner and trying to find the perfect gift. Or it could be a story of a young girl climbing a mountain, but the mountain is a symbol for the struggles of her depression. So many cozy games revolve around a feel-good story, bringing our full-body experience to fruition. January 2020 marks the beginning of the subreddit r/cozygames. This is a small subreddit dedicated to people discussing, well, their favorite cozy games. This year is when we see Animal Crossing New Horizons and other cozy favorites like Spiritfarer. But the following year is when we really see the explosion. March 19th, 2021 is when fan favorite Cozy Grove released. And only 2 weeks later, we see the creation of the other, much larger subreddit, r/cozygamers. Now, I'm not saying that with 100% certainty Cozy Grove was the catalyst for this subreddit, but it is a very weird coincidence that I feel comfortable putting faith into. We even see the first spike in Google Trends for cozy games. I think it's safe to say that it was time for cozy games to take over every corner of the internet. We started to see YouTubers like Gab Smolders, who mostly played, you know, gamers games, start adding more wholesome games into their content. And new channels emerged like List the Lass and Cozy Game Night. There was a huge wave of coziness crashing over gaming that you just couldn't escape. A mass focus on games that made you feel good deep down instead of focusing on defeating enemies or grinding your way to the top of the leaderboards. Wholesome Direct is a showcase of the best cozy games of the year to check out. It started in 2020 and has really started to gain momentum. This is also what tailored the Steam sale that I spoke about earlier. 2021 is also when we started seeing a bunch of the now endless number of articles titled 27 Switch Games to Hide in Your Oversized Pillow Fort With, or whatever. So, what does the future of cozy games look like? Are they bound to die out like the text-based RPGs of the 90s? Or are they going to be a staple of the gaming universe from this point on? Well, I think the answer lies somewhere in the middle, where we will see less and less independent developers focus on cozy games, but there will always be some around. So far, I'm seeing this as similar to what happened to horror games in the mid-2010s. There were always horror games since the early days, but around the time game engine software became more accessible to the layman, people got their hands on it and started making their dream game. And for some reason, most of these dream games were horror.
Oh my God!
Slender the Eight Pages, FNAF, Vanish. Of course, there were larger games too, like Outlast and The Evil Within. But here it is, 8 years later, and most of your AAA games are still shooters and RPGs, while itch.io is about to bubble over and spill shitty horror games all over the floor. I imagine that cozy games are going to end up the same way. We'll have our favorites that stay in the zeitgeist forever, but most of the visual novels, simulators, and point-and-clicks will be stored on itch.io until the seams blow. I mean, I think we might be closer than you think. These are some of the cozy games that I really enjoyed and recommend. I hope you can find a new favorite. But now it's time for me to cuddle up on the couch because I'm about to head into the Skull Cavern. Wish me luck. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.